Laura sort of like, you know, playing violin. So how did you get Helen involved with the record?
Through the listening party, really. She joined in for Tourier, yep. Dex's, and I kind of had a thought that I might like to work with her one day. So I asked if I could send her I Love the New Sky, and she loved it. So when we got to Rockfield, me, Daniel, and Fireball Sandra,
yeah.
We did like 5 or 6 days, and then asked Helen to come for the last 3 days.
Because, well, you know, cause, I mean, obviously you've got some interesting collaborations. I was going to ask about Pearl Charles as well.
Yeah.
Because Pearl Charles, I remember being given the album by a guy called Leo, who runs a record label called Canine in Focus Wales a couple of years ago. Yeah. And it's, you know, and Pearl Charles's record, I mean, if anyone here has heard Pearl Charles, but it's almost like ABBA, it's a little bit like the Concretes. It's this amazing Swedish indie pop. It's kind of like lo-fi, but you can imagine it being, you know, being played in stadiums. I mean, how did Pearl get to sing on your record?
Well, again, through the listening party, I heard her voice and thought she would go on my list of people I'd ask girls, you know, to sing on the record. And she came back really quickly and said she'd love to do it. So I sent her the track, and within like 5 days, you know, it was back, you know. Michael Rolt, her boyfriend, partner, engineered it over there and sent the vocal back, and it was perfect, you know, really great. And, you know, there's a few other people that didn't respond, but she did. Yeah, so Rose Keeler Shaffler did all the other parts, who is in the band as well, the live band, so, and she's great.
So, I mean, just going back to the centre of me, I mean, what is that song about? You know, can you elaborate on what the inspiration was for, you know, for that tune?
Well, I suppose it's a love song, really. I think it came from a place. I was just really fascinated by the intro, the on the acoustic guitar, and I was really proud of it. I don't know the inspiration. I guess it's like, you know, there's just like within everyone, there's like, you know, hopefully lots of joy, you know, coming from a connection with other people, I suppose, which would be a nice way of putting it. So I thought it sounded a bit like Caterpillar by The Cure. Yeah. I thought it sounded a bit like Dex's Midnight Runners, Come On Eileen. And all these, you know, We Live in Hope, you know, these sound a bit like those tracks, but it sounds nothing like them, really. It just sounds like that.
I was kind of thinking, like, you know, bits of Northern Soul and little bits of pulp in that intro and the sort of like rhythm as well.
Yeah, well, we all love Jarvis, don't we?
Yeah. But always, absolutely. Yeah.
But I wasn't trying to copy him or anything.
No, I don't think you were. I mean, one question that I've always wondered, I asked this for a lot of, you know, people that are playing bands and then do sort of like solo projects. I mean, when you approach, you know, writing solo records, do you take a different approach to how you would with the band? I mean, you know, I've got to ask, are there any times where you've written a song and you thought that song was obviously for your solo project and it's ended up with the Charlatans or vice versa?
Yeah, there has. There was a track called, I forgot what it's called. Tracks of My Past.
Yep.
That actually came out on a record I did with Peter Gordon. What was originally written for Modern Nature.
Oh, right, okay.
And everyone liked it. Everyone in the band liked it. It was recorded. It got to the. I mean, it's actually out on the. There's an album the Charlatans put out recently, like a box set kind of thing, and that version came out on that. But it, you know, it just didn't feel like it was going to go on the album. I didn't want it just not to come out. So I tried it with somebody else. But most of the time, I just write for projects. You know, so it's like this. I wrote all these songs for this because it was, you know, COVID. And I didn't see any of the band for, you know, for about a year.
Because it's probably fair to say, you know, that you've been, you know, since moving back to the UK from LA, you know, that you've been like incredibly prolific. You know, we've had sort of like 5 solo albums in that time. It's been a couple of Charlatans records in that time. Would you say that, you know, that being back in the UK did make you much more prolific as a writer and an artist?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, lots of, you know, it's like another phase of my life, really. I mean, I dust around quite a lot in LA. Went to parties and swam in swimming pools and stuff like that, and took lots of shoes. So when all that stopped, I just thought, okay, well, it's a new chapter, really. And I was really looking to move back to England anyway. And so I did, and I started writing a book, and then I went to Nashville to do Oh No, I Love You with Kurt Wagner, which was really inspiring for me. I wrote the book, telling stories, and then I became a dad, which was like probably the most inspiring thing of all time. I was always nervous, you know, thinking that it would stop things. I'm not saying that's why.
It's a massive challenge, trust me.
it just blew my mind, and just wrote written tons, really.